We have a fair amount of produce. We should be getting in some more trucks today. We can be a little bit generous, particularly on the bananas and the mangoes, who's ever over there.
Catholic Charities has been providing food in eastern Oklahoma for decades, and it's always been a bag it up and take it to the car kind of approach by our volunteers. It's been very good, and we've served, you know, thousands of people in that process. But as the community has come to us and seen leadership, they've asked us to grow in bits and pieces. It really led us to the breaking point before COVID, where we were seeing hundreds of families in a day, and we weren't really set up for it physically. And we knew that it was time to go to a client choice pantry, that the market would provide dignity that a regular bag of food doesn't allow.
We shifted so that we allow our neighbors to come in, shop with dignity, using a shopping cart, and they can go up and down the aisles picking and choosing items that they want. What we've devised is a system that after we take a little bit of information from our clients, we have our color-coded tag that will go on the front of their shopping cart. It doesn't mean anything to the client, but when our volunteers who are standing in the aisle see that, they know that corresponds to the number of people that are in their family. That also corresponds to the number of items that a client can choose.
If we look at our 37 counties, like 90% of them are food insecure, especially for children. Usually food is a symptom, honestly, to a greater issue. And so perhaps they don't have good transportation that can reliably get to work. Or perhaps they are calling in sick from work because they have pain and we need to get them into our dental clinic. Maybe they need to increase their educational capacity through a GED or English as a second language or various computer classes. And this process of Catholic Charities wrapping around all of the different needs gives us a lot of synergy within our programs.
So our volunteers that work here in the market are an amazing group of people. Within the market, the warehouse, and the kitchen, on a normal day, we probably have about 35 to 40 people that are doing various activities, and out of those 35 to 40 people, only 5 are full-time employees. All the rest are volunteers, so.
Clients can pick what they want. If they have a rutabaga and they don't know what it is, they can actually, there's a person right here that they can ask, oh, what is this thing? And you know, it's neat interaction with the clients.
People who are happy, they're smiling, they're excited to see the choices. And it's in those interactions with our volunteers, the clients we serve, that I think we feel that we become who we really are supposed to be. We truly are acting out the love of Christ.
And it's always such a rewarding experience. We have so many gifts in our lives that we just feel like we need to live our lives like being good stewards of those gifts.
Actually, it helps out so much considering I don't have no income right now and I'm waiting to get on my disability. So this is definitely a lifesaver. It really helps.
So Chef Michael, who's in charge of our production kitchen, has been with Catholic Charities now about 3 years. He brings a vast amount of experience and knowledge, not only within the kitchen, but he's also helping people, our volunteers, and when he goes into the warehouse, he can look at those items that are coming in and pick and choose to say that we can extend this life by doing this, or this is good, let's move it right out there. We have refrigeration and freezer capacity that well exceeds previously that what we had.
We want to look at it as giving that food as a way of dignity for the person so they can shop and pick it up, pick out what they want for the meals that they're going to prepare. For me, it's about not giving them food that they're going to get home and just throw away.
We are the largest client of our Northeastern Oklahoma food bank, so we get a lot of our food from there. We also get food from what I'll term as retail trucks. So they go around to the local grocery stores, pick up items that are near or that they have excess in when it's close to expiration.
At Catholic Charities, we know that food really isn't a scarcity. What seems to be a scarcity is the process, the logistics of moving it. And so we bring food in from multiple locations warehouse it in our two warehouses geographically, and then distribute it out to either facilities-based services or into like parking lots and partnership-based resources. And in doing this, we can reach out to 31 counties throughout our diocese and provide food in an equitable and innovative way.
We bring clients in to satisfy the hunger need, but there's so much more that our services can offer for our clients as well.
Thanks for coming. Take care.